In the sound hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا نكاح إلا بولي وشاهد عدل. Nikah without a guardian, a wali, the consent of the guardian of the girl, and two just male Muslim witnesses is invalid as if it did not happen. According to the vast majority of the scholars, Al-Shafi'i wa Malik wa Ahmad, and all the companions, without exception, it is not permissible for a woman to give herself in marriage without the consent of her guardian. Imam Abu Hanifa radiyallahu anhu, and may Allah have mercy on him, said a woman has a full guardianship over herself in wealth and in marriage. The right view, notice I did not say the more right view, it's not right and more right. The right view is the opinion of the vast majority of the scholars in the light of the supporting ahadith. So there is no room for a girl or a woman to give herself in marriage without the consent of her guardian. Now here is an issue. She already dead. I have many cases like that in the West and in the States. And you know that the father or the guardian wouldn't have any say, cannot object, cannot do anything. The girl can have a boyfriend and she can bring him home and the father cannot say anything. Yeah, it's haram in the deen, but he cannot do anything. He cannot even lift a finger. So I advise the father, after consulting him or the guardian, what is the problem with the boy, with the groom? In some cases, I don't like him. If you don't like him, please approve the marriage, because your daughter now is involved in adultery, in a condition of fornication, because there is no marriage according to the hadith without the approval of the guardian. The guardianship was granted to him to protect the girl. But there are some fathers and guardians who are so stubborn for no reason. I don't like him. He's not from my tribe. He's not Hyderabadi. He's not from here. He's not from there. He's not a U.S. citizen. He's not. I'm just giving some examples. Not necessarily this is the case in your question. So if the objection was for an insignificant reason, I beg the father to save his daughter and say, I approve this marriage. Yield. It's okay. In order to save your daughter from the fire of hell. And then when they have a child, he is a legitimate child. So this marriage, if somebody told her it is legitimate, and she got married, and in fact it is illegitimate, then the father later on approved it, they don't have to redo the contract. The marriage will be valid based on his consent or approval. And instead of waiting for a year or two, consult a scholar. Consult wise people in your locality. What should you do in order to find out? Because this is a serious condition. And before refusing a proposal, do not refuse it on your own. Istikhara and istishara. Consult elders, wise people, religious leaders, the imam in your community. Maybe your opinion is wrong, right? Ask your daughter, why do you like him? What do you like in him? We want to close the generation gap. We want to close the generation gap. Our children are not us. They do not think the same way that we think, especially nowadays. There is a big jump with the chat, with the social network and so on. They become entirely different than the parents, than the earlier generation. So if you fail to think like them, at least try to close in the gap by asking her, what do you like in him? And explain to her, what are the reasons for your objections? Some fathers do not discuss. Say, this is my word. If you want to go to hell, go ahead and marry him. But I disapprove the marriage. This is not the way you handle things like that. She is your flesh. She is a part of your soul. She is your daughter. So since you approved this marriage, now it is valid. Alhamdulillah wa shukrullah.